Welcome back, guys, to what I think is going to be a really amazing and eye-opening episode. This episode is going to be all about the Applejack line, because I'm going to show you how to set up the perfect food production chain. I had a huge realization while I was doing some research, and it's kind of staggering. And I haven't seen, like, I've definitely had no comments about this idea, so I'm pretty sure that, like, this isn't like common knowledge, which kind of staggers me, but it is what it is. So let's have a look at the existing Applejack line, right? We are currently producing grain over here, and our production's up at like 700, which is pretty good. And we've got potential for grain, and we're producing loads of grain, which is great. And we're shipping it up here to the Burgess Hill food processing plant, and then we're shipping it on this line, which runs from Burgess Hill North. So let's have the farm and that over there. And then we've got this station, which is Burgess Hill West. And we've got the food processing plant over here. And then we ship the food from Burgess Hill West along this line to the food distribution network. Okay, fine. Sounds good. That is the worst pile of crap you can imagine. Like, basically everything about this setup is wrong. Okay. Now, okay, fair enough. If we look at the the cache on these lines, and you know what, let's turn on all the icons so that we can actually see what the hell we're doing. If we look at these train lines, so this is the Applejack line, which is shipping grain up to the food processing plant. And if we look at the finances, now, forget the last few years, because obviously we've been setting up the Halo. Before that, it was making, I don't know, 2-3 million a year or whatever. And we were all going, hooray, 2-3 million, nice. That's appalling. That's awful. And I'm going to show you why. And we'll completely redo this. Right, and then we're shipping the food over here. Now, where's the trains on the food line? If I can spot one of them. Here we go. This is the line, the TF Food Maisley line. And if we look at that, look at the finances on this. Again, like, now this has been making some good money. You know, this was making like 8 million back over here, right? Which is awesome, isn't it? No, not really. Not really at all. As you will see. Okay, so how should this be set up? Well, the big realization is that you shouldn't be using grain at all on a food line, right? Grain should be used for processing into oil and plastic and stuff like that. For food, you only want to ship livestock, full stop. End of story, okay? Now, why? Well, because if you ship grain, then you've got to use the open cars, these things, right? You're going to use these open cars, and of course, open cars can't carry food, okay? So we want to use box cars, which can carry food. Now, box cars can carry livestock as well as food. Now, what that means is that this line can take the livestock up to the food processing plant, and then bring the food back to here, right? Now, if you want to make real profits, you want lines that carry goods in both directions, right? So the train, because at the moment our trains go up here full, make money, and then they come back empty and lose money. So yeah, if we change it to carrying livestock, they'll go up carrying livestock full, make money, come back, deliver the food back here, and that will make money. Now, what you could do is you could set that up, and then you could change the food line, move the station over to here, right? So that the food gets unloaded here, it'll automatically get transferred to the other station, and then you could ship that into here, right? Which is what I first did. But then I realized when you're unloading, right? Effectively, that loading and unloading time, you're losing money because your train is just sitting there not doing anything, right? It's not moving. If it's not moving, it's not making money. Also, so your train's going to pull in here, unload, right? So it's wasting time. Then your other train over here has got to load up, it's wasting time, right, before it can go over there. Also, you've got the stopping and starting time, right? So the best way to do it would be to have a station in here, a through station, and you send the livestock up here, you ship the food back to here, but you don't stop at this station, you ship it straight through, then you come back, pick up the livestock and up there. And that is what we're gonna do. So let's get rid of this and this and get rid of a bit of that. And this station's gonna go. Yep, that station's gonna go. And we're gonna put in a through station. We want a nice freight through station. We want two platforms. We'll do this as a 240, I think. We'll have high speed, definitely, and catenaries, yes. Yeah, something like that should be good. All right, cool. So we'll get rid of a bit of this line so that we can smooth it out nicely. Have a nice smooth curve coming in here. Let's take it back maybe one more. And high-speed tracks, catenary, yes. So you are going to come into here. Boom. All right. Now, we've got a train up there. So what I'm going to try and do is hook this onto the existing line so that the trains can get onto this line. So, yeah, there you go. Is that a good? Yes, that's good. Cha-ching. Alrighty. So now the existing trains are going to be able to come down here and get onto this line, which is nice. Right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch these vehicles onto the Applejack line. So train 8, we want to switch you to the Applejack line, and train 60, we're going to switch you to the Applejack line. Cool. TF Food Maisley. Right, so we can get rid of that line completely. And goodbye. Excellent. So not only will this improve like the cash and like the whole flow and everything, it will also reduce lag, because less lines means less lag. Right, so let's get this line sorted out. So we are going from, now I'm gonna change these names. Applejack Food Plant, Applejack Food Plant. All right, cool. And then this is gonna be, right, so we've got the food plant and we've got the food plant station. There we go. Applejack Farm. If you're into min-maxing, you're going to love this episode. If you're not, yeah, well, maybe not. But we are going to ride on some of the trains as well while we're kind of doing this. Right, so we want to hook this up with a nice road. So a road just going like that. Nice little S bend to hook that up. Good. Okay. What do we want next? We want to sort the line out, don't we? Add station, farm station, get rid of Burgess Hill North, remove. So this is going to go from the farm station to the food plant. Then it's going to go straight to Maisley Freight Central and then back to the Applejack Farm. Right, so only three stops. So it goes farm to plant, plant to food distribution, and then back to here. Cool. Right, now we can sort the trains out. Hooray. So, vehicles. We are going to upgrade all of these. And let's see, we want, replacement, 25%. And these are currently open cars. In fact, we want to get rid of that loco as well, because we're going to upgrade to newer locomotives. So, set vehicle. We are going to go with the Class 185. Because it's fast and it's got good pulling power and it's sexy because it's blue and I like blue. So we're going to have one of those and then we're going to load up with goods wagons to just short of 240 meters. So let's crank this up to 233. That'll do fine. Cool. All right. So that's going to replace our vehicles. Okay. So in terms of getting the line set up, that's it. And it's like, it's the line is just so much simpler now. You know, if you think about it, it's like so much more elegant. And once you realize, it's so freaking obvious as well. So, yeah. Now, once this is running, we can smooth this line out here and we can get rid of the old line. Now, as well as that, we've also got a food distribution line, which is running from the from this plant here over to somewhere else. That is just like a waste of time, money and effort. Much better to just ship all the food back here. Well, I suppose I could put in a truck line rather than this train line. This train line is terrible. I suppose I could put in a truck line. And we'll also put in a truck line from here to Gangu as well. And we'll distribute the food that way. All right, so that's what we're going to do. So now this is one of our oldest trains. In fact, this may be our oldest train. Look at this. Oh, it's such a shame. And this is the Yorkie Pud Express. I'm going to have to move the Yorkie Pud Express over to over by Yorkie Pudshire. So yeah, you're going to go. Poor train. Do we have a depot on here? Yeah, we do have a depot on here. So you go to the depot. Let's get it into the depot. Wave goodbye. Wave goodbye to our steam train. Oh, it's such a shame. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, steam train. There he goes. So he's out of there. Pause. And bring up the depot. And oh, God, it pains me to sell it. I should have a museum line or something. Should I just leave it there for now? I might just leave it there for now. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna leave it there. Right, so we'll just forget about you for now. Now that means we can get rid of this station, this line. Okay, so that's gone. Get rid of that little bit of road. We can get rid of these bits of track as well. Okay. So we want a food distribution by truck going into here. Now the thing is, I've got to completely redo the road network here. So I'm not going to faff about with it too much. I'm just going to do it in like the simplest possible way. So where's the center of my my commercial? Well, unfortunately, the commercial is kind of split on both sides of the station. So we would actually need to deliver to two spots, unless I can actually get either a bridge or a tunnel, and I'd probably need a couple of them. So what's the coverage from this now? Oh, it's covering most of it. Okay, that'll do. So we'll deliver to this one here. Alright, so we're going to want a bunch of trucks hauling down to there. We'll start off with four trucks. We also want to do one for Gangu on the other side. Okay, so that's the distribution setup to them. Obviously, we've got the halo, the mega halo, distributing the food over here. So that, I think, guys, is it. Have I forgotten anything? I don't think I have. I think that is everything. So all we need to do now is turn it on and make sure that the trains get to where they're supposed to be going to. Don't get flipped around. This is going to be the Applejack Cart 1. and then we'll name the other ones, the Applejack Cart 2, 3 and 4. Switch this up. Ah, yes. The first one has upgraded. Good, excellent. Here we go. You're going to pull in here. Nice and easy. And are you going to upgrade? Yes, you are. Hooray. Awesome. So I tell you what, while we're waiting for this, we'll get rid of this so that you guys can actually kind of enjoy the views. Such as they are. I'm going to turn this off because having the land use on makes it a bit laggy. So you can enjoy that, and I'm going to rename the trains. So this can be the Applejack Cart 2. Applejack Cart 2. There we go. Now, once this pulls in here, and get upgraded. And boom, right. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to quickly save the game at this point. Let's see, we're in the middle of 2020. Now, I'm going to show you what happens to this line. Let me clear this out. So, if you want to clear the stuff out from a station, then, let's see, where is it? Here it is. Easiest way to do it is just... Like, yeah, let's take the catenaries off, apply, and then put the catenaries back on, yes. And basically any upgrade will clear any existing stock. So we've cleared everything out now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do a save at this point, and we'll run it on so that we can see exactly how this performs, right? But then once we've kind of seen what happens to it, I'm actually going to roll back like for the next episode back to 2020, because there are about a million other things that I want to do before we start actually running it on. So like I want to do like the next part of the Halo. I've got major improvements to do to some of the passenger transport. Confusefoot has got some major traffic problems. I've got to rework the roads. So there's tons of stuff that I want to do before we actually start running it on. But I want to show you what actually happens to this. So let me do that save. Alrighty. So all the hard work is done. Now we can enjoy the fruits of our labours. This is gonna be kind of fun and kind of awesome. So let's have a... Well, actually, I want the other two trains because I want to name the other two trains. So let's have vehicles. And we can get rid of those two trains now. For now we can. Let's ride along with train A. So let's turn it on. I'm going to run it on slow just for a little bit, and then we will speed it up afterwards. So if I bring up train A and train 60, then I can get rid of that so that we don't have the orange lines. Cool. So this is going to be the Applejack Cart 2. Applejack Cart 3. Applejack Cart 3. And then this puppy over here is going to be the Applejack Cart 4. Alright. Now, pause, because I don't think this is set up correctly. Yeah, this isn't set up correctly. I don't think. Let's have a look. Yeah, and what are you doing on this platform? Well, they use two, but I guess they'll use two platforms automatically. That's pretty impressive. I didn't know they'll do that. So you're waiting there. They're all the trains are bunched up, unfortunately, which is not the best thing in the world. So I should have a look at my signals. Okay, we've got no signals on this stretch. So let's put some signals in. Probably here. Yeah, let's put some signals in here. So we're going This is the thing. This should be coming down this way and going up on the left-hand side. Ooh, that's not good. I mean, it doesn't matter which side they go up and down on. If they really want to go that way, all right, fine. If they really want to go that way, I'll let them go that way. Cool. All right, go. As long as the trains are on the right route and stopping in the right places. So, you should stop at the Applejack Farm. And you do. This one should not stop. Right, now, what speed are you doing? 75 miles an hour. And now you speed it up. Now, that makes me wonder if I've actually upgraded the track. Let's have a look. Let's get rid of the Applejack line so that we can see the track. Track upgrade tool. Yeah, so he's just slowed down to 75 to go through the station. The station's upgraded to fast tracks. Okay. Yeah, the whole thing's upgraded. Okay, fine. So we can just let it run. Okay, so now it's going to be all about the production and more importantly, the profits. So do we want to see the trains? Is there any reason that we'd want to see the trains? I mean, we could see the individual finances on the individual trains, but I think probably we just want to see the Applejack line, really. And we want to look at the finances for the Applejack line. So we'll pop that up there. We'll get rid of the trains. And then, do we even want the stations up? Kind of not really. But you'll see now, all we've got is livestock appearing. And if we have a look at the farm. The farm has now seen that it has the potential to process livestock. And the food plant has now figured out, if we go to the details, that it requires livestock. And it's got the potential to produce 4,000 food products, because it's linked up to Maisley and to Gangu and somewhere else. So it's got loads of potential. We've got the end of year going on. Thank you very much. All right. So our trucks are running around doing their thing. Probably not getting very much food distributed, but they are getting some. It is putting some out there. What are we producing now? We are producing 92. All right, and this thing has identified, it's got the potential. Why these numbers aren't the same, I don't know. I've got to confess, that does, because like, wouldn't you think that that would be the same? If this has the potential, now they're the same. So if this has got a requirement of 184, then surely the potential here should be 184. So I would have thought those should like pretty much always be the same number. But they are at the moment, so that makes sense. Hooray! It's good news. All right, let's see. Now, it's going to take a little bit of time, obviously, for this to start making like full-on profits. But what we want to see is kind of how quickly this ramps up. So let's have a look at the production. And the production is already going up pretty damn quickly. We're already up to 132 at the plant. We're producing 160 at the farm. Should we, a bit of a ride on one of the trains while we're looking. Let's get rid of that. And let's have a bit of a ride on cart three. And let's turn off a whole bunch of icons. So let's turn off, we definitely want those off. We'll turn off signals and depots. And we'll turn off the boats and the airplanes for sure. In fact, we'll turn off all the road vehicles. I guess we'll leave the stops on for now. We'll leave the industries on. All right. All righty. So, how are we doing? Production at the farm has gone up to 192. And production at, oh, look at this, production is picking up at the food plant. Now, we're running a decent frequency on the trains. Let's actually go up to the food plant. Because what we want is our trains to be delivering food, delivering livestock nice and frequently, so that we keep the production level up. Because every time it's got nothing to process, the production will start to fall. So we want frequent deliveries. Where's the next train? Yeah, the next train is coming. If we look at the details. Right, now we haven't got any left. Now the production's gonna start to fall in a few seconds. Unless this train gets here before... See, it's starting to fall now, and look how fast it falls. And now the next train is here. Oh! And that stops the fall in production. And now it goes, oh yeah, I've got some to process, and now the production will start climbing again. But we're already out. Yeah, we've used up what we had. So now we need the next train to arrive before the production starts falling again too much. See, it's starting to fall. Fortunately, our train has just arrived. Excellent. Now that's keeping, because this isn't falling too much, it's keeping the production level up here, right? Because the demand, the potential here is still staying high. Like, why that is higher than that, I don't know. I really don't know. But, yeah, it is what it is. The point is that our frequency is good. We're keeping it supplied. We've got great demand. 3,885 demand. And this is going to keep going until it can satisfy that demand or the production chain gets blocked in any way. So this is just going to keep climbing now. So let's see, where are we? We're 2022. I think at this point... Now, let's see, last year our profitability started to climb a little bit. Now, because of the way that I've set this up, like if I was setting this up in like a regular game where I was struggling for cash, where I hadn't got a nice 3.5 billion cushion, then I would run this with a shorter number of trucks until we'd reach profitability, and then I'd ramp up the trucks. But for this, for the purposes of this, I know what the ultimate capacity is going to be, so we'll run it with a full set of trucks. Right, we're up to 270, 242. Now, what we should look at now is like how much the trains are carrying. So you're the next train coming in. How much have you got on board? You're carrying 29 livestock. Now, bear in mind, this can carry a total of 169. So we're carrying a very, very small percentage of what we can actually carry at full capacity. And yet, we're almost making a profit. Like, we're not making much of a loss, right? Now, why is that? And it's because this line is incredibly efficient. Because the trains are fully loaded, not fully loaded, but because they're carrying products for, 75% of the length of the route. So the only time they're not carrying anything is when they go from Maesley Freight Central to the Applejack Farm. That's the only point where they're not making money. And we've cut out the loading unloading times. So, yeah, this is very efficient. And so it's amazing how little you need to carry in order to just break even. How's production doing? We're up there. We've just passed 300 and continuing to climb. Very cool. Right. You know what? Let's have it's a little rotting. Yeah, let's get rid of that, and we'll have a bit of a first-person ride on the Applejack line. Now, I'm definitely going to have to dress this up and make this line look really beautiful, awesome, and gorgeous. Because it's a bit of a mess. There's a lot of terrain smoothing that needs to come out. It's a bit boring. We need some trees. We need some extra buildings and stuff. I'm going to get some extra buildings off the workshop. I was looking at the workshop this morning, and I found a whole load of additional buildings that we can use. And also additional bridge types, additional tunnel entrances, all kinds of cool things. There's some really cool stuff being put onto the Steam Workshop. Right, come on, flip around. Let's have a ride back again. Yep. Now, in actual fact, this is actually going on the right side now. I mean, before it was running on the left-hand side, and now it's actually running on the right-hand side, which is the right side as far as we're playing it. Like for British trains, obviously British trains should travel on the left-hand side, not on the right-hand side. But I would imagine that differs across Europe. I don't know. I think somebody left me a comment and said that in France the trains travel on the left-hand side. Which kind of surprised me. I'm sure somebody will leave me a comment. In fact, I'm sure lots of people will leave me comments and let me know how it works on the continent. It's a little bit laggy, but it's not really too much of a surprise. We are running it on 3x speed. And here we go. So there we go. We've just done a pretty much a full journey. I suppose I should have done a journey, right, on regular speed. After that quick journey, we're getting up to 400, closing in on 400, 360 at the food plant. Right, now what's that doing to our profitability? I would think we should be close to, if not profitable at this point. Let's have a look. Oh, close to. Very close to. What are you carrying? You're carrying 35 food now. Oh, we're very close. Oh, we're within 700,000. We only lost 700,000 last year. This year, we will make a nice profit. And then that profit is just going to climb and climb and climb, and we are going to make a freaking fortune on this line. Now, why is this like so staggeringly important? Why am I making such a big deal out of this? Well, when we start playing the next series, and we're going to be playing on the American map, I want to play on medium difficulty because we're playing on easy here, right? I want to play on medium difficulty, and at the start, it's kind of difficult, right, to make money. The way to do it is this and fuel. Now, these are the simplest production chains, right? Fuel is just ship crude oil to a refinery, and that produces the fuel, and you ship it out, right? You can do exactly the same thing as we've done here with a fuel line. The fact that you can do it with food as well, I've now discovered, right, is peachy. Now, I want to show you something. If we go and look at the line profitability, let's pause for a second. Do I want to pause? Yeah. By the way, can I just show you the TGV? If we look at the TGV finances, let's see. Yeah, we made 37 million, then 20, 30 million. So, yeah, TGV is making quite a lot of money when you consider it's only got four trains. That thing's flying. Yeah, so the Halo trains are making 100 million a piece. That's awesome. But look at this. Rogi Oil, right? It's just like running three trains. It's making 20 million. Now, why the hell is that? And if we go and have a look at Rogi Oil, you'll see why. And it's because it's using this exact same principle. We're shipping oil. This is the oil well, right? So we're shipping the oil down to the refinery, right? And then we are shipping some fuel back up to Haverhill. So we're getting a bit of extra profit from that. If we look at Confusedford Oil, let's have a look at Confusedford Oil. This is taking the oil from Confusedford over to the refinery, processing it into fuel and shipping it back. Now that's exactly what we're doing, right? And then it gets shipped from there to the distribution network. So this is how you make money, right? This is how you make really big money, by having these lines that are carrying products both ways. What else have we got? Where's the other oil one? See, Honkelbrief crude oil is making nothing like. That's just a truck line, so kind of understandable. Rogi Fuel's only making 1.5 million. Yeah, I mean, this is the big money. Now, we want to be making the same kind of money from this, so let's let it keep running, and we'll see what happens. So yeah, when we start our next game, we're going to be looking for opportunities for fuel and food, because they're the simplest. We could also do the same with the with construction materials as well, because that's just stone to a construction plant, construction materials plant. What are they actually called? Yeah, construction materials plant. Those three work. I think the rest are all more complex chains. So, like producing steel, you need multiple components. You need coal and iron ore. Planks can't be shipped directly. So you can turn logs into planks, but then the planks need to be shipped and made into something else, like goods or tools or whatever. Same with plastic. You can make plastic out of grain or processed oil, but refined oil, but it then needs to be made into something else. So, yeah, those are going to be the three chains that we're going to focus on in the early part of our next Let's Play series. How are we doing? Yes, we are now into a profit situation. We're only like halfway through the year. I think at this point we'll probably maybe skip ahead in time a little bit. Okay, so we've just skipped ahead 6 months and we've just gone through the year end. It's now January 2024 and we made 5.5 million last year. All right, now I'm just looking for one of our trains. Can't see. Where are our trains? Here's one of our trains coming in now. I should have the icons on. He's only carrying 60 livestock, which is what? A third of capacity. and we're making 5.5 million. So this line, once it gets up to closer to full capacity, it's going to be making a freaking fortune, because the the costs are not going to increase. The costs are now fixed. So 3 times our current capacity would be potentially making a profit of something like 45 million, which is not bad from four freight trains and 3 stations. So yeah, that is freaking awesome. Now, I have brought up the lines for the 2 truck routes because I want to illustrate something. If we look at, oh no, I didn't jump to there. If we look at the finances for these 2 truck routes, you'll see that, oops, that they're not making any money. They're making a loss. Now, how come this is making a fortune, right? But these aren't making money. And let me pause it. What? Do I need to pause it? No, I don't really need to pause it. I can explain to you without pausing again. If we look at the demand, right? Now, if we look at the demand of somewhere else. There we go. This has got a demand for food of 115, okay? And this one has got a demand for food of, click on it, here we go, of 107, okay? Now, if you compare that with the total demand that this factory is seeing, which is over here, this is seeing a total demand of 3,400 at the moment. So you've got a demand of, like, a combined demand for somewhere else and Gangu of like 200, and 3,200 demand down the line here. Okay, so it's gonna put a proportion of the food onto these 2 truck depots, which is proportional to the demand. Right now, what's 200 as a percentage of 3,600? It's a fairly small percentage, so it's only putting a very small amount of food onto these 2 lines. So in actual fact, we're running with way too many trucks. If we look at that's not going to show us. That's not going to show us what they're carrying. So we'll have to go to this line and look at line 1 and 2. Let's change the name. If we look at line 1 and 2, look, this is carrying 7 of a possible 80 capacity. This is carrying 4 of 100. So we've just got like way too many trucks. So if we change this and say, you're the one carrying the food. All right. You go to the depot, and you go to the depot. Got him just in time. And you, oh, you've got 4 food. You've got 5. Okay, you've just dropped your food off. Right, go to the depot. We only need 1 truck. So you're in the depot. You're heading for the depot. You're heading for the depot. Good. All right. So now, this thing should actually be carrying probably close to full loads for 1 truck, in which case he should actually start making a profit on that line. So we need to do the same thing with line 2. So we want to change this to, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You can go to the depot, you can go to the depot, and you've got food. Oh, quick before you pick up, you can go to the depot. And we'll take this down to 1 as well. I mean, we could probably run 2 trucks on here, but I think we'll just run 1 for now. So yeah, you've delivered, so you can go to the depot. So get rid of that. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. So yeah, I suppose the lesson to learn from this is, first of all, is first how you actually set up the line, making sure that you're carrying products both ways. And then when you're setting up the actual distribution, to be aware of the amount of demand that you've got on each leg of the distribution, and then kind of judge the vehicles that you need appropriately. And I have been way overestimating, like when I'm doing this, putting in these like little local routes, which is only supplying like one city, I've been way overestimating how much is required in terms of vehicles. So in future, we're going to be making a lot more profit. So we're coming up now to, we're in November. So we're coming up to the end of the year again. Let's say we made 5.5 last year. We're already at almost 8 million this year. Production at the farm is up to 600. Production has just gone over 600 at the food plant. We don't actually need that train up, do we? No, we don't. Get rid of the noise as well. Quite noisy, the trains. I do like listening to the trains, though. No, they're not as bad as the hovercraft. The hovercraft really are freaking noisy. You know what? Let's see. Let's get through to the year end, because we're almost at the year end. And then I want to talk to you about a couple of other things that we're going to be addressing in upcoming episodes. But you can see how, as soon as this runs out of food or livestock, that production drops. So it's really important to keep the frequency high. And as soon as it's got food again, that production just starts to climb. But as long as you've got good frequency, then this will just keep climbing all the while. It won't drop back. If there's a too long a delay, and the production here drops too low, then it'll drag the production here down. And then the two of them will never actually get up there, because they'll constantly be dragging each other downwards. So they'll go up and down, up and down, up and down, and never just keep going up, up, up. If we look at the charts, you can see we had a dip when we did the change, but now it's just going to be up, 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 and this is going to keep going up as long as we don't have a blockage on the line. Now, let's talk about blockages. So, because we've got good frequency of trains here, shipping this stuff out isn't a problem. So this station isn't going to get full until we reach maximum capacity, right? What we do have to watch out for is that this station doesn't get blocked, because if this reaches its maximum capacity, then production here will drop like a stone, because they just stop production if they can't distribute. So yeah, so what are we going to be talking about in upcoming episodes? Because I've been figuring out some other stuff, and for example, airports and airplanes. It might even be the next episode. I'm not quite sure, but we're going to completely revamp our air traffic, and we're going to make it work so much better than it's currently working. And it's actually going to pop. I'm going to kind of go back to what this was before, but different. There you go. That made a lot of sense, didn't it? You'll understand when I actually do it. What else? I'm figuring out passenger transport, like local passenger transport, so like buses and trams and all the rest of it. And I wanted to show you this, because this is kind of interesting. Confusedford is running at like 13%. It's very poor, because it's got a lousy setup. We've got traffic jams going on, and let's see, if I zoom in, we can probably see some traffic jams. The traffic is very snarly down here, but it gets snarled up in... Look, there's a traffic jam going on through this section, and it's really holding everything up. It doesn't look like much, but actually, that area there is a real problem. right? And it completely screws up our bus routes. And this is why we've got long queues of people waiting, because our buses are getting... Look, there's another one here. Look at this. It's just jammed up. And there's a bus. Now, okay, it's going to slip down the side, right? But there are certain points where it is... Look, I think we've got... Yeah, our buses there were being held up because these cars are trying to get through this intersection, right? So this is slowing our buses down. And slow buses means low profits. So yeah, we're going to sort that out. If we go over to Bickety's, on the other hand, which has got a really nice transport system, where we've got the outer tram ring road shipping people around, and then we've got the inner bus routes with a decent road system. Could still be improved, actually, but it's like it's okay. It's not too bad. Now, if we look at Bickety's Hollow, 63%, excellent, right? We are moving people around. And that is being reflected in our population, which is now up to 5,300. Staggeringly good news. Right, enough of that. Let's get back to the Applejack line and have another little look. We're coming up on 700 production. Same at the food plant. What are we doing? Now, we did almost 9 million last year. We've already done 9 million this year. We're only in September. So we're going to exceed 10 million. You know what? Let me run it on for a couple more years. And let's see what this can really get up to. Okay, so here we are now in, what year is it? It is 2031, so we've run on for about 6 years. And let me pause it for a second. We made, I think, 13 and then 18 million. Then we had a little hiccup in the distribution chain. Now, I didn't touch anything. I just left it alone. The production dropped like a stone. It really, if you get a blockage in your distribution chain, it really affects production dramatically. But as soon as it figured it out, it recovered and it's just grown steadily. And we made 19.5 million, 27 million last year. So I think it is fair to, I mean, production is now over 1,000 at both the farm and the food plant. I've been looking at this and thinking, you know what, we could probably use a fifth train on here for just to increase the frequency slightly, because when this runs out, you can see how quickly the production drops, and that means that the production is growing slower than it should do. So yeah, I think one extra train on here would actually be a good idea. I might, when we go back to 2020, I might just do that. I might throw an extra train on. But you can see it's continuing to go up. The production is continuing to go up. How full are our trains now? Let's have a look. Let's pick this one. We're still only about 2/3 of capacity. So, yeah, well, I mean, we made 30 million. Yeah, we could make something like 45 million off this line. If we continued running it and let it get up to full capacity, which you know, we could always add an extra train onto this line and probably get up to, what do you think? I would think somewhere around 55 million, something like that on this line. So there you go, guys. That's, let's see, where are we up to? We're up to September, we're already up to 17 million. So, yeah, we're going to make about the same again, maybe a little bit more this year. I think we might maybe hit 30, something like that. So there you go. That is how you create what I think is the perfect food production chain. Livestock, frequency of trains, good distribution. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention that our two truck lines, now that we're just running a single truck, for the appropriate level of demand on the three distribution lines, They're making profits now. Look, this thing's making 200K from one truck. One truck making 200K. Another one down here. This one truck making 200K rather than making the big losses that we're making before. So yeah, that is how you do it. And you can see, look at all the livestock we're producing. The food chain now down here definitely needs to be improved on the Mega Halo, because there's loads of food sitting here which needs to be distributed out to the rest of these. And you can see the same applies to the production materials and the fuel that's sitting over there. This is continuing to grow, and it will continue to grow, or it would continue to grow, except that in the next episode, we're going back to 2020 and we're going to go and make a whole load of other improvements. So there you go, guys. I hope that you enjoyed this. I hope that this was informative, and I hope that this helps you in your own games if you're playing. So we will leave it there. We're over 27 million. We're coming up to the end of December. 28.9. Will we get any more? No, I think that's going to be it. Yeah, that's going to be it. 28.9 million. So almost 30 million from that line. And it's still got a ways to go. All right, guys. I will catch you for the next episode. I really hope you enjoyed this as much as I did. And it really was a revelation. I'll catch you for the next one. Peace out.